Hello, Aldersgate class. I hope this finds you all well and managing things as well as possible during our period of isolation. The cases seem to be growing, and we have no idea how long we'll be in this state, but we do have each other to pray for with. And we're fortunate to have the services and the Sunday school lessons that we can attend. This is Sunday, July 26th. It is the eighth Sunday after Pentecost. Boy, we've been at this a while, haven't we? And we're concentrating today on a reading from Romans and on a reading from the Gospel of Matthew. So I'll begin first with the reading, and we'll have a brief discussion about it. A reading from the letter to the Romans, chapter 8, verses 26 through 39. Likewise, the Spirit helps us in our weakness, for we do not know how to pray as we ought, but that very Spirit intercedes with sighs too deep for words. And God, who searches the heart, knows what is the mind of the Spirit, because the Spirit intercedes for the saints according to the will of God. We know that all things work together for good for those who love God, who are called according to his purpose. For those whom he foreknew, he also predestined to be conformed to the image of his Son, in order that he might be the firstborn within a large family. And those whom he predestined, he also called. And those whom he called, he also justified. And those whom he justified, he also glorified. What then are we to say about these things? If God is for us, who is against us? He who did not withhold his own Son, but gave him up for all of us, will he not with him also give us everything else? Who will bring any charge against God's elect? It is God who justifies. Who is to condemn? It is Christ Jesus who died, yes, who was raised, who is at the right hand of God, who indeed intercedes for us. Who will separate us from the love of Christ? Will hardship or distress or persecution or famine or nakedness or peril or sword? As it is written, for your sake we are being killed all day long. We are accounted as sheep to be slaughtered. No, in all these things we are more than conquerors through him who loved us. For I am convinced that neither death nor life, nor angels, nor rulers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor powers, nor height, nor depth, nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus our Lord. This is the word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God. This reading is very interesting in that we are reminded that God is with us always. There come times in our lives when we question that, and that's okay. During difficult moments, sometimes we can ask, where is God? And this reminds us that God is always with us, watching over us, that nothing can separate us from the love of God in Jesus Christ. But we also have to do our part. And we are reminded what Jesus has done and for us to be followers of him. And we have to follow his lessons, which are not always easy. Do you remember this particular mosaic that I showed it to you in class one time and talked to you about what Lauren Wright Pittman says about this mosaic, what motivated her to write it or to produce it, and what she hopes people get from it. She, remember, told us that we see God, or we see what Jesus Christ did for us in two different ways. We see him as a king, as someone who is glorified, but we also have to remember what happened to him in order for us to have the types of beliefs and the faith that we have. We want to see him as a glorious king, sitting in the heavens, but really, he is with all of us on earth, and it's not an easy road to hoe. What he was crowned with, a crown of thorns, and he's holding like a thorny weeds in his hand, and he has hands that must do work. So we have to remember that we are called to follow Jesus, to believe that God is with us, that the Holy Spirit acts through us and through other people, and that if we believe that, then we can be assured that if God is for us, who can be against us? And that neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor rulers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor powers, nor height, nor depth, nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God. So thanks be to God for that. Now we'll listen to a video of the Vagel brothers singing, "My Faith Looks Up to Thee."
My faith looks up to thee, thou Lamb of Calvary, Savior divine. Now hear me while I pray, take all my guilt away, oh, let me from this day be as thou hast
This is a reading from the Gospel of Matthew, chapter 13, verses 31 through 33, and then verses 44 through 52. He put before them another parable. The kingdom of heaven is like a mustard seed that someone took and sowed in his field. It is the smallest of all the seeds, but when it has grown, it is the greatest of shrubs and becomes a tree, so that the birds of the air come and make nests in its branches. He told them another parable. The kingdom of heaven is like yeast that a woman took and mixed in with 3 measures of flour until all of it was leavened. Then on to verse 44. The kingdom of heaven is like treasure hidden in a field, which someone found and hid. Then in his joy, he goes and sells all that he has and buys that field. Again, the kingdom of heaven is like a merchant in search of fine pearls. On finding one pearl of great value, he went and sold all that he had and bought it. Again, the kingdom of heaven is like a net that was thrown into the sea and caught fish of every kind. When it was full, they drew it ashore, sat down, and put the good into baskets, but threw out the bad. So it will be at the end of the age. The angels will come out and separate the evil from the righteous and throw them into the furnace of fire, where there will be weeping and gnashing of teeth. Have you understood all of this? They answered, yes. And he said to them, therefore, every scribe who has been trained for the kingdom of heaven is like the master of a household who brings out of his treasure what is new and what is old. This is the word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God. I think this reading goes hand in hand with the reading from the book, from the letter to the Romans. The mustard seed is so small and it can not be noticed in other seeds, so that when the seeds are thrown out, it's very easy for the mustard seed to be seen, not be seen, and then for it to become planted and develop. Once it grows, it's a very large, spectacular bush and allows birds to live in it. And but as Christians, we tend to have this sense that everything is supposed to be tidy. It's like that mosaic that Lauren Wright Pittman did, where Jesus on one side is a king, on the other side has been crucified and has hardworking hands. We think that Christianity should be very finely planted. It should look like a field of soybeans with a straight rows. But what this is pointing out to us is that this is very messy business. And Christianity grows in the midst of all kinds of places. It is a treasure that is to be appreciated and worked at growing to its full strength. So think of like how we think about, we have to have, you know, the liturgy just so right, or the hymns have to be just so right. Think about just allowing whatever comes our way to come our way, to be a wild growth in our faith. Right now, we're feeling isolated, and it's more difficult for us to feel like our faith can grow. But remember from the reading from the Romans that nothing can separate us from the love of God. And we can allow it to grow as a treasure, grow as a magnificent bush, grow like yeast grows, grow like a treasure hidden in a field. And what each one of those people does who finds a treasure, they give up everything in order to receive the treasure. So like we want to have a sense of order, but it can't be there for us. Therefore, we are to go where the wild things are and to allow the glory of God the Father, Jesus his Son, and the Holy Spirit surround us. And no matter how awkward or unconventional it looks, accept it and move forward as the people of God, behaving in the ways, the very difficult ways, that Jesus has taught us to behave and to love and to continue to seek social justice. So, thanks be to God. Now we'll listen to the hymn, Seek Ye First the Kingdom of God, sung by the Maranatha Singers. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, you gather us together in our faith journey. Trusting in you, we join one another as a community of faith on a journey to grow ever deeper in our faith, in our love, in our desire to long for you. Along the way, remind us of your love, of your sacrifice for us, of your ever mindful presence. Let us never lose hope along the way. Help us to be strong, strong in faith, strong in love, strong in our desire to be ever mindful of your presence, for it is in your strength and love and the graces you bestow upon us that we can go out and share in your love and faith with all those in our community. It is in the name of Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Now, brothers and sisters, may you go forward into this week knowing that the Creator, the Redeemer, the Sustainer are with you always. And may you continue to live out your journey of faith knowing that God is with us always. God be with you. I will continue to pray for all of you, and I look forward to being with you again next Sunday. Bye-bye.